The World Gold Council recognises the urgent need for new technological solutions to environmental challenges, with climate change a critical priority, and these solutions need to be robust, accessible, and commercially viable. The National Research Council of Canada, the NRC, is playing an important role in addressing these challenges. We visited their new facility in Mississauga, Ontario. They spoke to us about the importance of their research and its potential contribution to climate-focused solutions, as well as its impact in advancing science and R&D.
I'm Robert Black. I'm a research officer here and team lead in accelerated materials discovery and process optimization. So here at NRC Mississauga, we really focus on bringing together and combining aspects of AI machine learning, laboratory automation, and domain knowledge to really push forward and make more efficient how we approach and perform science towards a specific objective or goal. So our goal here is really focusing on decarbonization and reducing global greenhouse gas emissions.
My name is Parisa Karimi. I'm a research officer here at National Research Council of Canada, working on electrochemical processes. The problem that we're trying to solve here is reduce the CO2 levels in the atmosphere so that we can reverse or halt the impact of global warming.
For this project, we are focusing on a triple approach towards accelerated materials discovery. So the first aspect is focus on gold catalysts on the material for a self-driving laboratory. So really focusing on accelerating how we look at gold at the material scale. Then beyond that, we have to scale it up to an electrolyzer device. So the second portion of the project is focused on taking that material and optimizing it at the device level. And then finally, going from material to device, we really want to look at what would be impact of the gold material. And so we focus on life cycle and techno-economic assessment to really quantify how impactful our accelerated discovery process will be when it comes to commercializing gold as an efficient catalyst for the CO2 electrolyzer.
Gold in nanoparticle form is a great catalyst that could help to convert carbon dioxide to a series of chemicals and fuels that we could use on an everyday basis. Gold is also very stable. So unlike other metals, gold in environment that is aqueous or watery, it could last for longer term. So it doesn't corrode, it doesn't wash away, and it makes it a good candidate for the catalyst. Gold also comes in variety of shapes and sizes, for example, in nanoparticles, spheres, needles, rods. It could be alloyed or doped with other materials, and that's why it makes it a good candidate to have a variety of different properties for this type of conversion we're looking for.
My name is Kenneth Chu. I'm a technical officer here, and I work on the materials for electrocatalysis team. So the incorporation of gold electrocatalysts into our devices comes with its own set of challenges. So there's many parameters that can affect the performance of our final device. So these are things such as temperature or pressure or flow rate. And fine-tuning each of these parameters manually, it's a very complex and time-consuming task. So working in parallel with our self-driving labs, this platform will accelerate the research and development of gold as an electrocatalytic material and will enable us to build next generation devices with high performance and high stability.
Hi, I'm Alex Whittingham. I'm a research officer here at NRC Mississauga as a part of the accelerated materials discovery team. So what you see in front of you is what we call a self-driving laboratory, which is a combination of AI, robotics, and chemistry rolled up into one platform designed to do research autonomously. This is where the electrolysis happens. So it's going to be transferring the samples that we prepared on this platform and putting it into our electrolysis platform for analysis. And what we're doing, what we're looking for, is we're monitoring the gases coming off of the electrocatalyst in real time. So we can see the amount of carbon monoxide coming from the headspace and quantify it directly using that instrument. So the purpose of accelerated materials discovery is to be able to find exceptional materials in the fewest amount of experiments possible. And this will greatly accelerate the pace at which we're able to combat climate change.
The work that we're doing here is not really just focused on one project, but really laying that foundational framework for how we approach and accelerate really our experimental procedures and really shifting towards a new paradigm in how we do science.
The WGC is proud to support these advances. We recognize the value of collaborating with centers of research excellence such as the NRC to maximize the impact of new technologies in benefiting the planet and its people.